for you know, giving me time on a Sunday afternoon for the Success Story series. So yeah, before we get started, if you could just introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about your background, that will be awesome.
Yeah. Anyway, thank you so much for having me over here. So I am a mechanical engineer, and I work with a company called Thermax Limited, which is into the domain of energy and environment. I was very fortunate to have joined the organization when it wanted to, be perceived as a global brand. So there were a lot of special initiatives where we had to work with the board of directors to be perceived as a global brand. And so I started my career in pre-sales, and I moved to business development. So one of the initiatives of business development was to introduce new markets for Thermax as a market. So it was identifying, it was about building business frameworks for these markets, for these countries. And post that tenure, I moved to Philippines, where I took care of the direct sales. It was like a startup organization for us because we didn't even have a address in our calling card. So it was right from, building up a customer preference. It was building up a entire market for us in a new sense for that. So after that successful stint, I took care of international sales for one of the divisions called as the absorption cooling division, where I had to take care of the targeted international markets for us predominantly, and to take care of the P&L balance for that as well.
Wow. So that's like a very impressive career. So how long were you working with Thermax?
So I started off my journey in 2014. So I've been working with the company for 6.5 years. Again, very fortunate to have, shifted roles in intervals, which gave me a lot of learning career, a lot of learning curves which happened. And like I mentioned to you, I was also a part of a lot of strategic decisions that had to be taken for the corporate per se. And there were special teams devised to directly report to the MD and the board of directors, where we had to take strategic decisions with respect to how the organization needs to be perceived, what is going to be the future for the organization. So there was a lot of learning curve that I had in the last 6.5 years working with Thermax.
Awesome. So why did this whole thought of doing something in management come to your mind?
So to be very honest, like I told you, with the kind of growth that I had in Thermax itself, I was learning a lot of management or so to speak. I thought I was learning a lot of management processes during the job role itself. To give you a very different perspective, COVID was one of the major reasons why I thought I wanted to do an MBA. When COVID happened, I realized the kind of decision-making abilities that some of our senior management leaders had, getting into a 360-degree perspective of business making. So when COVID happened, you had to understand how each and every decision impacted a lot of things in the business, financial decisions, operations, supply chain. And that was something which, that I wanted to look out to. And that is when I decided that probably I need to do an MBA to get myself into a decision-making, a fear of decision-making. So that was something that, I decided, that was when I decided that I wanted to do an MBA. And so that's how my journey of MBA started. It was pretty late. So I decided only back in, 4 or 5 months back, that's when I decided that I wanted to do an MBA.
Right. So what was the process like? First is obviously GMAT, and then figuring out what schools to apply. And were you very clear you wanted to apply to Indian schools only, or what went in your mind when you were thinking around all those things?
So again, I had a very different story altogether. So I wrote GMAT 4 years back. That was something when I decided that I didn't really introspect too much at that time why I really wanted to do an MBA. So I just wrote GMAT, and I thought, let things go with the flow. And post giving the GMAT, I got shifted to Philippines. And I thought that was a great opportunity for me in my career. So MBA took a back step, and I got into Philippines. I took over the international sales. So a lot of things made MBA take a back step till COVID really hit onto it. So once GMAT was taken, then then when I really decided that, look, this is the time that I want to do an MBA, introspection was something which was very, very important. You know, it's very easy to say, why MBA? And it's the most difficult difficult question to answer. But I just broke that question down into smaller steps. Why MBA? Where do I see myself 10 years from now? Again, a very difficult question, but I broke it down. I said, okay, where do I want to see myself 10 years? Where do I want to live 10 years from now? So that's a very easy question to answer. So I, having spent most of my life outside of India, my answer was India. So it was very clear that I wanted to stay in India. I wanted to work in India. So what did I want to gain out of an MBA? That is when the where MBA question, gets boils down into what are the colleges that you want to list down? What are the attributes of each of the colleges? And what are the outputs that each of these colleges will bring into your own personal life? So that was pretty much, my journey of how I decided to do an MBA, and then how it boiled down to where finally I wanted to do an MBA. And yeah, that was my brief thought process on that.
Right. So how did you go about it? So you applied to all the IIMs, or you wanted to apply to, how did you go about with your research in terms of where you would want to apply and how you want to go about it?
So yes, again, in terms of doing the research, I first try to reach out to people who have done an MBA. I don't have a great connection to people who have done an MBA, at least in my family. So I had to reach out to people in my extended family to just try to gain a perspective whether my thought process really resonates with the real world or not. So that was something where I tried to reach out to people. And then slowly the list of, the intangible and tangible assets of doing an MBA and doing an MBA from schools. So yes, once it comes to India, I think it's pretty clear that, IIMs is one of the first choice for anybody to do so. So each of these IIMs, irrespective of their rankings, each of these IIMs really give a different brand proposition altogether. So if you talk about A, B, C, L, I, all the IIMs give a very different output to what it was. So I reached out to all the alumni of A, B, C, L, I, and ISB, and just trying to figure out 5 years from now, if I want to be the person, or if I want to be in the shoes of this person that I'm talking to. And Lucknow resonated very, very closely to what I wanted to do. So that was my one of my phrases. In the IIMs. And yes, so I applied to
So you said you applied to, you reach out to literally every school IIM, every alum from every IIM to, finalize that, okay, IIM Lucknow actually resonated with you a lot more than, the other schools.
Not only, yes, that was the process, but it was not only Lucknow, there were other colleges, so which is why I eventually applied to other colleges in the list, but yes, very closely, which resonated was Lucknow. So that's how my thought process was when I wanted to get into this journey.
Right. So tell us about the interview process. So one part is obviously the application where you have to submit your SOP essays and stuff like that. How was the interview process different? And what schools were you interviewed with? After you submitted your application.
So most of the applications for the 1 year MBA, after having an experience, will all resonate or will all try to figure out the why MBA question and why do we want to really choose you. So even through the application process and the interview process, the college is trying to really gauge what value are you going to bring to the college and what value will the college give to you. And does that really resonate together really well? So that is something which was tested all throughout the application. So, when you're applying to an MBA, you should be very, very clear as to what exactly you want to gain out of an MBA. Not just the tangible. Okay, everybody knows that, you get out of MBA, you're going to get a job, you're going to get growth, you're going to get career. But what are the other intangible things that you're really looking at? The diversity, when you're interacting with hundreds of people all coming from different backgrounds and different thought process, that itself is an intangible asset that somebody really has to sit down and really value. So even in the interview process, the question revolves around what exactly do you want to gain out of an MBA, and will the college really be able to give you that benefit or not? So it really just posts what is the story of pre-MBA, what is the story of post-MBA that you want to go to, and can the college bridge these two stories or not? So the interview was all the interviews that I took. So I got an interview for Lucknow, Indore, and XLRI. And all the three interviews resonated pretty much on the same lines.
So, you know, you mentioned about this clarity aspect, right? That, you know, why MBA, and, you know, how does it make sense for you with respect to the school you're choosing, and what does the school, you know, what is the value that the school brings to your career goals also? Was this, did you get all this clarity more through talking to the alums, and, you know, or what was this process? Because I think this is one of the major concerns that most students have, right? That they know they want to do their MBA, they want to apply to top schools because obviously they have a pedigree with the kind of job roles that they have already done. And obviously the reason of why they want to do an MBA is all to go to the next level too, right? But this formulating of these answers, which you mentioned, is so important in this whole process. What do you think was the, you know, really helped you through this understanding of getting answers to these kind of questions?
So yeah, like I mentioned earlier, it's very difficult to get answers to all these questions. I was in the shoe earlier, so I know that probably I didn't have a real clear answer to many of the questions that I personally had in my mind. So one thing which was very, very useful for me was understanding myself, understanding what I wanted to do. So that's the first step. So you really want to understand what you want to do, what you want to gain. The second step is reaching out to people who have gone through the same journey. It could be from any, it's irrespective of the college. It could just be people who have gone through the same journey as you. So you can reach out to anybody who has done an MBA, try to gauge their perspective, because it's very different from the perspective from outside than somebody who has done it. And then probably close down to, people who have done it from the college that you're aspiring to go to. So yes, talking to alums was a major part in getting to know a lot of relevant things that you want to gain a perspective of getting into an MBA. So you just have to break the process into smaller things. If you just look at, why MBA, nobody's going to answer it. You just have to break it down into smaller portions and then try to attack these smaller questions and then put all together, and then hopefully you'll figure out what exactly you're trying to do.
Right, amazing. So when did you get to know that you've got an admit, and what has been the process after that?
So I got to know, I was a round one admit. So I got to know by, I think, late of December 2020. That is when I got to know. So post that, you have a very formal session where, they build WhatsApp groups, and then they start sharing pre-modules, which is required to gain some perspective or to gain some base out of the MBA program. So in the 3-4 months, it was pretty, with COVID going on also, it was very confusing as to when is college going to start. So that anxiety was there for me also. But it was very smooth. I think the communication between the college and between the candidates was extremely smooth, was extremely clear into the mindset, which reduced all our anxieties. So they were very clear as to, look, this is what we are going to do, and this is how we are going to take care of you. So that reduced the anxiety for a lot of people. So they were very clear in the communication and the thought process that they had.
Right. That's amazing. So this is like a full-time program, right? The IPMX program So now there is some confusion around when it will actually start and all that, right? Because of the situation right now.
So I'm formally inducted into the program. So it's been 1 week since the program has started, and I'm formally inducted into the program.
Okay. Okay, awesome. So all the best, Sai, for this. I think, whatever you shared with us has been very insightful. And like I mentioned, I would definitely like to have one more session with you where we discuss more in detail about the IPMX program and, understand how what kind of students should be actually applying to these programs and how they should leverage these kind of programs to expedite their entire process or next step going ahead. Thank you so much. I really enjoyed talking to you and, a lot of great information that you provided. And I think we'll connect again, for the next discussion that we have on IPMX soon.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah.